first. Vayne being able to six auto practically any tank and take them out of the fight, if not outright kill them, incredibly powerful. So Gnar and Mundo must be respectful of that kind of
bot lane back to base.
Revenge stepping up, eating some damage from Impact here yet again. Xersei seizing the opportunity to go after the first Drake of the game. 7 minutes and 45 seconds. Not particularly early, not particularly late. Just about on time here for Immortals and their favorite horse, as that means it's the first neutral objective of
the
game.
Whoa, why is the favorite horse? What about Destiny down in the bot lane?
Did he get a dragon? I don't think so.
I mean,
how many horses on this team have killed dragons? That's the favorite horse. Finscarin is not the favorite Mundo, and he will not go where he pleases. First blood for Insanity.
A trap. Insanity's got 60% HP. If he walks back over here and isn't careful about it, thrown up into the air with the damage coming down, throwing out the wall with the Shuriman soldiers.
Finscarin needs a little bit more damage, but he cannot find it. The man is ignited, and Destiny grabs the kill. I believe Finscarin killed himself on accident. The health
ultimate coming through there from Finscarin. You may be right. The health cost of that cleaver could have been the difference in that situation. Immortals, they're just going to get solo gold onto the Vayne, allow Vayne to take down this bottom lane turret. Yes, top lane turret will fall, but I actually think even if you don't get first tower here, it's still potentially better for Immortals because all the gold will be concentrated for Raze here. You know, where it becomes more of a question is, if you're not going to defend the tier 2, it's not such an even trade.
Play attempt in the mid lane will not work out. Jizuke is forced to use the flash, but he gets away just fine otherwise. Meanwhile, topside, the tier 2 turret has been demolished.
Thanks, go down.
I mean, there's a reason. Never mind. We can talk about Vayne here in a moment. Jizuke is getting away, but a shockwave to turn things around. Ignar flashing forward to make the plays here with a pulverize. Insanity will fall, and Jizuke grabs the kill on that one. Nicely done from Evil Geniuses.
Ignar played that really well, to be honest. You know, headbutting Destiny away, denying any potential of appeal. Then the Q flash comes through, the ignite as well onto Insanity, locking him up long enough that his soul laners could come through and finish off that kill. He's going to get them another turret here. So now three towers.
Finscarin is here to contest. Should be a 50-50 at least. Evil Genius is going in. Drake down to 1,800. Ignar tanking up in the front lines. The Drake is secured. Finscarin is not able to seal it away. Now we've got him tanking up in the front line. Going to be dropped very low. Xersei grabbing the kill. Immortals taking the fight. Going after the CC and the additional damage off the side here as Revenge buys a little bit of extra time. Insanity with the shuffle back on the impact.
Comes Raze.
Kills off Revenge. Triple kill over to Raze. Is it going to be a Quadra? No, it doesn't even matter. The Emperor takes it.
They're even going to force out Svenskeren's ultimate there in retreat. They've got full control of the top side. There's always the risk that if you don't have vision on the Baron as EG, that I think he could have just walked it out, but he E'd backwards, and then all of a sudden Svenskeren's on top of you, so you've got to spend the ultimate. Impact, though, trying to create advantages for EG. They have been losing out around these 5v5s, but Impact has maintained the side advantage here, pushing Revenge out again, getting this turret very low. He should be able to potentially knock that one down, and we'll see if he can open up some of the map for EG. You know, if he can create a solo
Drake. Evil Geniuses has two down here with the Drake. They're taking this. There's no contest from Immortals because Immortals are going in for the Baron instead. Mundo is the target. Vayne does the damage. Say goodbye to all your health. That's what Vayne does to tanks. Ignar is still burning away, but the man stays alive. Revenge underneath the enemy turret with Impact about to be shot down here with Xersei getting the last kill with the Rampage. Immortals, two kills for nothing. The Drake was even abandoned by Evil Geniuses. They don't even get that. They are now deciding the best course of action. Send Deathly down over to the Drake. Deny the soul because Immortals are going there immediately after Baron. They cannot fight for the Baron in the meantime. Huge play coming out from Immortals to get the Red Bull Baron bomb.
Yeah, that is so big. Finding those two isolated members there, yes, it was the tanky members, but everyone was around with them, and they knew the rest of EG wasn't there. Now going to catch out Jizuke here.
Oh, Jizuke barely staying alive. Destiny and Xersei, not quite enough firepower to take him down, but over the wall comes Revenge. The interrupt from Ignar, enough to keep his mid laner alive, but the tier 2 turret in the top lane is looking at a different reality. The wave has collided. Xersei and Insanity are here and ready to push this one even further. And
the fact that they could just go for the Baron, that they have the turn to do it. Raze now looking for this 1v1.
Raze is at the point where he's getting hyphy on the Vayne. Easy peasy. 1, 2.
On your opponent there, even got the stopwatch, has both the summoners ready to go.
You're going back to the fountain immediately. Raze is at a point where as long as this man is properly protected, he will be able to end this game here for Immortals. He does a good job condemning Ignar away, but the protection that I just mentioned is not there thus far. Destiny coming in, looking to stop him, but a nice shutdown coming out from Impact. Into the back line goes Insanity, grabbing a kill on the enemy AD carry now as well. Despite the fact that they shut down the big man with the big plan, it still don't matter because Immortals strike back harder. They get a 2-for-1, they're pushing into the enemy base, and Evil Geniuses has no way to stop them.
Yeah, this is going to be difficult here. They do clear out that mid lane wave.
But Immortals showed up today, and they are just outplaying Evil Geniuses at every turn. The draft has put them in a spot where it feels like the game is almost unlosable now, and they have managed to get to this point safely enough to make it so EG was never pulling ahead. Revenge with a good disengage up here. 0-1-5 on the Camille, just constantly providing pressure and threat off the side. Spinskaren getting engaged on yet again as the damage pours through. Revenge continues leading the charge, thrown up into the air now with a lot of damage coming down. Orianna Shockwave is there. Nice shuffle back onto 2. Insanity buying some time here with the stasis. TP shows up, but it's nothing but a free kill. Impact in the back line going to be answered now with Raze getting away with the final hour. A little bit more damage takes him out, but the onslaught of shadows brings in
Impact's
the counterpunch.
Winning.
Immortal still looking to get something done. Never mind, I cast her curse the hell out of it. Impact's in the back line, tearing everybody else up.
Easter right here. He is separated from the rest of the team. They want to go for the engage, but Vayne is not with the squad.
And that will let Evil Geniuses know what's going on. This is a very fast Baron take. It is already down to almost nothing. It will be secured by the side of Immortals. Ignar tries to initiate, but the man is already dead. He's a beef kebab. He's gone. Holy moly, nicely done from Immortals, turning it right back around.
Impact
wants to go in, but you're not going to be doing anything now. Definitely trying to kite away. Triple kill. Back over to Insanity. The shutdown on the enemy mid laner. The Bud Light Ace with the Baron with the teleport into the enemy base. Immortals will take their win off that fight.
Nicely done by Immortals. One small misstep in that bottom lane, but the clean ace over by Baron secures them the upset win over EG when they need every single game here. Coming down to the wire on this playoff race, it's a big one.
Immortals getting the dub 19-7, 32 minutes in. They'll take down Evil Geniuses.
Really nicely played. I think the